Hey guys, it's me, Christy Lee, and the last couple of days have not been awesome. First of all, I lost two of the videos that I was trying to put together for you guys because the app that I use to edit my videos decided that it didn't want to work anymore. And this is an app that I paid for to be able to use for a year, and it just, I guess it went on early retirement, I don't know. So I tried a few things to try to get it to work, and none of those seemed to help. So I uninstalled and reinstalled the program, and guess what? Yes, go ahead, I'll wait. I lost all my video, all of it, for the last two or three days of videos that I've been working. One of them was like a spend the day with me. Sorry, you're a little crooked. Maybe I'm a little crooked, I don't know. It was kind of like a spend the day with me, and I had been stitching it together for days trying to get that up for you guys, and I lost that. And then another one was the one I did this morning to tell you guys about what happened to us yesterday, and I could not get it again to save the clips I needed to put in there. So I won't be able to put the clip in here either, because this is gonna have to be a straightforward blog, no editing. I can't use my program, so for a while it might be like this. Anyway, so what happened yesterday, Eric and I came out of the job at about 3:30 yesterday afternoon, and Eric started saying some curse words, if I remember correctly, and I said, "What?" And he said, "Look at your truck." My back window of my truck busted out. Glass everywhere. The little lift hydraulic, the things that hold your window part up, like we have the lift back hatch thing, and then if you don't want to lift the whole rear of the truck up, the whole back door, you can just lift the glass. Those were broken, you know, splayed, and the top piece that holds the glass up when you lift it, broken. Nobody saw anything, nobody heard anything. Eric thinks that maybe someone with a truck with a ladder on it or pipes or something could have possibly backed into the window, busted it, and then took off like jerks. But I think, at first I thought it was because of the heat. I thought maybe it got too hot in the car and it exploded. But we definitely, number one, would have heard that, I believe. Number two, there would have been a lot more glass on the outside than on the inside. And there was a lot of little pieces of glass on the ground right by the back bumper. But the big chunks of glass were either still stuck to the top where the plastic was or inside the truck. So I put into Google 2004 GMC Envoy hydraulic malfunction back rear window shatters, and I found pages and pages and pages of people talking about this happening to their Envoys all over the United States. This has happened. Some people have had it happen two and three times. It would shatter, they'd get it replaced. It would shatter again a couple years later or whatever. People are saying it's a manufacturing thing. It's some kind of error. The GMC customer service is apparently blaming it on the heat in Florida, even though, you know, there were counts of people living all over the United States where it's not hot and it's not cold. It's none of this. It happening to them as well. So I don't know. I don't know what happened. All I know is that our back window got busted out. This is the second time in a year. You guys, if you've been here for a while, you know that I think I said it on my channel, I'm pretty sure, but if you don't know, last year, February or March, we had a tree branch fall on the back of my van, on the top of my van, in the middle of the night, and the branch broke off on the back hatch. I'm doing this like you can see what I'm doing over here. On the back hatch, and busted the back windshield out. We drove around for a year with garbage bags and duct tape on the back of the van. Then, in the beginning of this year, January, we get rear-ended, smashed into. It bends the back latch the door. What is it called? And if we had replaced the glass in the van, it would have got shattered again. Now, 8 months after we get the new vehicle, the back glass gets shattered. What is going on? I feel like this is some kind of bad karma catching up to me, or... And then I get in the truck after that, and I have my sunglasses on my head, and I hit my head on the door thing, and it breaks my sunglasses. I can't drive without my sunglasses. My eyes are so sensitive. I can't do it. Okay. So that is what our last 2 days have been like. Oh, and also the little kitten. I don't know if I told you guys about the little kitten that was sick on this channel. I know I talked about it on my other channel. Little kitten passed away Sunday night. I think it was Sunday night. Maybe it was Monday night. I can't remember now. He finally passed on. Thank goodness he's out of his misery. Or, you know, we still have no idea what happened to him. And he held on for so long. And we feel horrible that we couldn't afford to do anything for him. We tried to make him feel comfortable, make him feel loved. It just sucks. Well, him and his sister were the only two kittens left out of that bunch, and now his sister has been missing for five days. I think the new neighbors stole her, I think they did. And if they can take care of her, then fine, it's not a big deal. She wasn't my cat, she was just a stray kitten that I happen to enjoy having around here. That's fine, as long as they take care of her. Anyway, and then we come home today, and we're looking at our fish tanks, and my favorite fish over in the tank number 3, my male sunburst Platy, he's not doing so good. He doesn't have clamped fins or anything, but he's kind of just laying around on the bottom of the tank. I swear. I don't know what oh, Lord, don't let me say that. Please. No, 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 no. Knock on wood. Give me some wood. Wood? Wood? I need wood. I am so ready for something good to happen. Like, we really seriously need to catch a break. It's like one thing after another. You know, Eric told me when we first got together that he had incredibly bad luck and that I should get used to bad things happening if I was going to date him. I don't know why I didn't run then. I'm just kidding, babe. I love you. I don't think you're a bad luck charm. Things happen to people all the time. It's not the end of the world. We're gonna get through this just like we get through everything else. Okay? It's gonna be fine. I'm telling you and I'm telling myself. It's gonna be fine. Anyway, so I made a claim on the insurance, and by now they hate us because we just 8 months ago made two PIP claims after the accident that we got into, and now I had to make a claim about our back glass shattering in the middle of an empty parking lot. And I got this feeling like they thought I was trying to scam them. Like, how does that even happen? Because first of all, we have to pay a deductible to get our glass fixed. I mean, they cover the rest of it, but I'm not getting anything out of this. Why would I smash my own back window? Doesn't make any sense. No sense at all. So, anyway. So the deductible is only $250, which is a lot better than $500 or $1,000, which I've heard of people having. The issue is that this week's check, tomorrow's paycheck, is not going to be great. We are behind on rent by a couple of weeks. I mean, we pay weekly, but we paid last week. We have some catching up to do is what I'm trying to say. Thankfully, our landlord is so, so, so understandable, and he's never had an issue. As long as we get caught up, and which we always do, not a problem. We also have to pay our cell phone bills, and I know that cell phones, you wouldn't think are a necessity, but in Eric's line of work, they absolutely are. His boss, his superintendent, his cohort, everybody needs to be able to get a hold of him, tell him where he's going, if he needs to leave one job, go to another. He has to have a phone. I hate to say this, might have to let my phone stay off for a little while because mine is not an absolute necessity if I am staying at the job with him. As long as he can get a hold of me, not a big deal. I have to deal without my YouTube and without all the other stuff that I get to do on my phone. But if it's something that has to be done, then it has to be done. I might act like a little brat and I might pout a little bit, but you do what you have to do. And now I lost my train of thought. That seems to happen a lot. Rent, phone, lights, car payment. We have to make the car payment. We cannot go without making the car payment. They have a device set up on our car. They give us 24 hours from the date that the payment is due, which is every Friday. If it's not paid within that 24 hours, they remotely shut it off. We can't drive it. That can't happen either. We have to be able to get to work. On a good note, I worked so far 16 hours this week with Eric's company, making $10 an hour. So that won't be on this check though. That'll be on next check. And next check should be a decent check for us. So if this could have just happened maybe like next Friday or the Monday after that or something like that, it'd be okay. But no. Everything seems to happen on the weeks where we don't have any extra money coming in. Never on the weeks that we do. And I know that that's why we should have savings. And actually, if you can see this board right here and the notebook that I don't have, so we'll just pretend this is it. I have started budgeting. I have started writing down absolutely everything that has to come out of our check, his check. I don't know why I keep saying out, well, because I'm working. Down on that, it's a large dry erase. I made it into a dry erase. It wasn't actually, I think it was like a back panel on a large LCD TV screen or something like that. I don't know. But I cleaned it up and it works perfectly as a dry erase board. So I write down all our bills for the week. I also have in this little notebook what we spend every day on cigarettes, lunches, day drinks, 2 liter at home, and dinners. And if there's any extra bills, gas, things like that. So I know exactly what we can spend every single day and make sure that we do not go over that budget. We started off this week with $160 to get through the week, and I know people are like, I could do that. But we had to put $40 in the gas to make sure that we made it to, because we're working almost an hour away from our house every day. So $40 in gas, $30 had to go on the lights. We pay weekly on the lights as well. So that's $70 gone. That takes us down to what, $90? And then we spend $10 a day on cigarettes. And it was Sunday. I don't know. Cigarettes every week is $70. Lunches, we've been spending $5 to $7 on. Luckily, we had already pre-bought cheap dinners so we could make it through. It's been working. It's been working really good. And like if Eric is like saying he wants something and I'm like, it's not in the budget, and he's actually been really cooperative, which is awesome. And I think that if he gave me this kind of control over the money every week, we might do okay. I mean, not always. Obviously, there's going to be times where we just don't bring in enough. And, you know, there's things that we aren't going to be able to take care of. But I think if we continue this budgeting thing, we may be able to actually put away a little bit of money like normal people do. And then when things like this happen, or like when we blow a tire or we get a bubble like we did 2 weeks ago, we'll have a little bit of money put away for situations like that. So I'm hoping that that's gonna happen. Okay, I can't think of anything else that I want to rattle on about in your ear. So I guess I'm gonna let you go. And I'll keep trying to work with that application, my editing software thing, to try to get the spend the week, spend the day, spend some time with me video up. And I may post up on the Facebook page the video of the damage to our back windshield, just in case you want to see it. And before you think about buying an Envoy, you should check that out. Also, some of you have commented that you don't have Facebook or that you don't do Facebook. So I have started an Instagram for the YouTube channel, and I am thinking about doing a Twitter for the YouTube channel. So if you guys could just let me know in the comments what social medias you use. If it's something that I'm not currently using, maybe I could sign up for it so that we can, you know, interact on a more, something, words, you know? Because I'd like to be able to, you know, like, talk to you guys and not have to come on and make a video, you know, a 20-minute long video just to tell you one little thing. I'd like to be able to just, and be done with it. Totally forgot about the Facebook Live stuff. I'm sorry. I know there are other live applications that I could use. So we'll figure it out. Just let me know what social media thing that you use so I can get signed up for that so that we can be friends. Okay? Okay. All right, guys. Thank you, as always, for sitting there and letting me ramble on about nothing and listening to my problems. You guys are the best. The best. The best. The best. Oh, don't. Why would you do that? Don't do that. Don't look in my nose. Ugh. I'm just kidding. I love you guys. And I will talk to you later. Bye.